The transcription I did of the Rush song Analog Kid that Geddy Lee played bass on, and you can find that at Musento under Advanced Learning Songs. So yeah, this is the first Rush song I've actually ever written out and transcribed, and I think it's always been because Geddy Lee, he's such a great player. He's kind of scary, and he has his own technique that I don't quite get. He does a lot of stuff with one finger, and how he's able to play his lines with one finger is beyond me. But I think that's why I've always avoided transcribing any of his stuff, is because it just kind of don't understand how he gets the lines that he does, and it kind of scares me. But I probably should start doing more, because there's just a wealth of good information in studying some of his lines. A few things I'd like to point out that I had to really watch out for was one, articulation. I had to really focus and try to play the notes long. If I played them short, which I may have a couple times, you'll see it kind of stands out. And I had to keep reminding myself that they're a power trio, and that he's got to get a big sound and take up a lot of space. So thinking that and playing long notes really helped. Another thing was all the different key. I'm pretty sure they're just key changes. I'm not sure how, if they notate it, or, but I notated it by just doing different key changes. I don't really like to read accidentals too much, so I just made a whole new key to avoid reading a lot of accidentals. Another thing was the opening lick. I had to try to find a way to get that nice and smooth and up to tempo. I tried different ways, and they all seemed to kind of made me fumble around a little bit. I even went on to YouTube to see how he might play it, and all I could find is that when he goes up to the B on the, it looks like he goes up here, but it was such a short little clip that I couldn't quite tell. So in the end, what I ended up doing was going, I hit an open D here, D, E, F sharp. So it's, instead of fingering the D like that, or like this, or I'm pretty sure he's not using open strings, because it just gets a little bit too much to handle, all these open strings ringing. So I'm sure he plays it up in this area. Whether or not he fingers a D, I don't know. But what I ended up doing again was open D, E, F sharp, A. That felt really good under my fingers, and I could get it quite fast. And then coming down, he either goes, which kind of makes sense, because it's just three, it's two triplets, and they're exactly fingered the same, just a string apart. Or, in the end, I think I did this the most, which again felt pretty good to me. And I just want to share the a couple other things I found. Sorry, I'm talking a lot here before I get to the play along, but just before measure 47, when he goes into the F for the first time, I do a lot of copying and pasting to do my transcriptions, and I happen to copy and paste just before 47 is that lick, and I copied and pasted, and I thought, geez, how is he getting down to that F so fast after playing? It's really tough. So I went back and I had another listen, and lo and behold, he goes, he actually doesn't play that lick. He just holds the A for a half note to give him time to get down, which I think is super cool. I mean, it to me, that just shows that he's always thinking about how he's going to play it live, and being true and real to the music. Yeah, I'm just gonna take it right from the top. The thing about this play along is all of the slower parts where we go into the F and the G, there's no repeat. And you'll see that on the screen, there's gonna be no repeat. So, okay, so this is gonna be Analog Kid at 170 beats per minute. The original was around 190 beats per minute. I'm just gonna play it along with a drum track, and we'll see you at the end. Thank you. So I think I might have messed up the last little lick there, but I think you get the idea. Okay, thanks for watching. Again, that was the Analog Kid by Rush. Geddy Lee was bass player. You can find that at Musento under Advanced Learning Songs. And thanks for watching. It's my real pleasure to be doing this for you, and I'm glad to be getting some positive feedback and comments on it. And I'm just going to keep plugging away and doing what I enjoy to do here. So thanks again for your comments, and thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time. Bye-bye.